Numero cinco. No, seis is six, right?
Seis.
Uno, yeah, dos, yeah. Cuatro, uno, dos, cinco. Tres, cuatro, cinco.
Oh, wait. Uno, dos, cinco. Tres, cuatro, cinco. Yeah.
Part
uno,
cinco.
Dos, tres, cuatro, cinco, cinco, six.
And I guess we're gonna try.
What?
Guess we're gonna try and finish this
El
thing today.
El
sangadito.
El
sangadito.
Quieres salir conmigo, mami? If you're watching this, you heard me. If you're pretty, and I like your personality.
Mostly that.
All right, what are we doing today, man?
Trying to finish. This is the magic hour, I guess.
Magic hour.
The part that I hate the most. So we have to hand sand in. It's going to take just as long to do these two little areas.
Holy crap.
Right
that, that's why Sebastian handed me this. It's because I got to go through and go on the inside on these hard spots right here and do it by hand, but...
The whole thing.
Whole thing. Sounds fun.
That's what makes it a pain in the butt. So magic hour engaged.
Magic hour engaged. It was a lot rougher than this, and it's just because this is so close together, it's hard to get the bigger tools in there, so we've been having to hand do it, but we found some smaller stuff, I think, so Sebastian could get inside of here, but this is what's coming along so far.
So be careful who you choose as your friends, for they might let you down in the end. Just when I thought real good friend I found, they pick you up.
Sanding, 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 and more
sanding and sanding.
And so we're probably gonna have to go until tomorrow, and we are still sanding, and it is the next day, but we are really close.
It's the hardest thing to find. It's just better an open enemy. A false friend is the hardest thing to see. Cause when times are good, well, our friends are plenty. In times of trouble.
All right, where are we working with today?
We're almost done. The final sanding buffing stage is happening. All we have left is this cap and the undersides of both caps, and that's it. Both stems are done. The base is done.
I remember when. Just when I thought everything was good, my friend, I guess I misunderstood. Thought that we had love and respect. But now
alrighty. Gonna put some oil on this puppy.
This is it. The moment of truth. This is either the most exciting part or the most disheartening part, because we'll see all of our mistakes.
Look at that.
And so by oiling it, we're going to be able to see...
It's to bring out the color, but we can also see all the stuff we missed as far as imperfections and all that, if we missed it.
Already bringing out the color. See, this is just normal sanded. And we've got this right here that I'm not going to touch.
It's wet. Don't touch it. Don't touch it, Jake. Don't do it.
Just look at this. Just look at all that.
So excited to see this color come out.
Huge difference. It makes a huge difference putting just one layer? Just one
coat.
Layer of one coat. Even the rocks are more purpley now.
So nice to work with. I much prefer working with. I mean, they serve a different purpose, but I much prefer working with oil over epoxy or polyurethane. That stuff's all a pain in the ass.
See, like, that's how light it was. And then this coat of oil just makes it darken.
Brings out the real color of the wood.
Let me put it this way. I took stuff off all three walls and put it all up on the shelf and still have space underneath it to put stuff on.
That's it.
We've pretty much got an entire coat on it now.
This is the monster. Well, definitely was an effort, to say the least.
Sebastian said this was your favorite piece?
I think this is my favorite piece I've ever made. Between the size, I mean, the wood is just, I don't know, to me, the wood takes my, like, I don't know. I'm nuts for this stuff, so, but the color of this wood is just so beautiful. I did nothing to it other than give a natural oil. This is grade A right here, and this is why it took me 10 years to use it, to use this piece of wood. And I have others just like it that have been waiting that long for their destiny. And that one day, I just got the idea and boom, that was it.
Alrighty, putting the finishing touches on it.
Couple coats of wax, and we're out of here. This one's already not warm, but you can see it doesn't shine up on the first one. You gotta rub it down a couple times.
So a couple coats of wax, I guess?
A couple coats of wax, we'll do two or three.
Alrighty, we got our first coat of wax on there. And it is shiny. It is darker. And it's beautiful. Let me get a close-up of what we're working with. See the purple rocks that have kind of come out? Man. Out in the sun, out in the open. Gave it its last one little touch, and that's it. She's done. That is the mushroom sculpture. Seb, you got anything to say?
I'm just excited. All I can say is now it's time to get this one out of here and make the next one.
True. We've got a lot more to go.
Couldn't be happier. This came out awesome.
Let us know what y'all think in the comments below. Give us a like for all the time and dedication we put into this, and also give us your money if you want this. I'm just kidding. But we'll have a bunch of other work, and then y'all know that Seb makes smaller stuff too. Also check the links. Y'all know to check the links. And this was my first experience doing anything like this, so this was definitely special for me, and I was surprised because of how quickly he got it done with all his expertise, 10 years doing this and 4 years in construction. This is still insane to me. All right, guys, I think that's it. Just support your local mushroom dispensary. Do they have this?
I don't know, but they should. all I know right now is that I can rub this thing off as much as I want. It's like it never finishes.
Wait, was that a, hold on. For they might let me down in the end. Just a thought, when I thought,